My name is Tom, and these are my friends, the Scrofiovians.
Woo! Yeah!
I did
today, in my
post.
The role of Bree will be played by.
She was polymorphed and got stuck like that.
There it is, perfect. There you go.
Perfect.
There's a cat in the frame now. There we go.
Perfect.
Outstanding. Excellent. This is now the second session. I have managed to successfully keep you guys kidnapped
for 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks in a row, right?
Please send help.
Okay.
I'm Brandon. I'm playing Rain.
Zeb.
Could
these scene transitions?
I am
flipping money.
I am.
Is this PG-13?
This is a PG-13 stream.
Oh, you let me play a bard, but I can't curse.
We can do it. Yeah.
I am Tempest. Do this.
Speaking of things brewing, why don't you give me a roll on a 20-sided die?
Oh,
Riley,
shit.
Riley, you go right ahead and tell us about your character.
I am playing
12.
Temerity.
Oh, finally, Tony.
I'm playing Gooble.
We did not talk to the person with the bright colors, who is, you said, seemed distraught last
yes,
time, right?
Yes, was quietly sobbing, I would say.
I
wonder if her husband got killed in a train station.
I took out loans to pay for a team, and they all bailed.
A team to do what?
A team in the tournament. In the brawl ball tournament. I paid good players, and I paid the entry fee, and they bailed. They took the money and ran. It's next week. 5 days. What day is it?
Hey, Tom, what day is it?
The 13th. The individual goes back to their rig.
Of what month?
Onyx.
Hey, so what happens if you win the tournament?
30,000 coins for the winner, 10,000 for the runner-up, 3 for third.
So, Google, is this a contact sport?
Absolutely.
Excellent. I'm in.
Google does not look to the GM, but writes the universe. There it is.
Yep.
It's on camera.
Yep.
It wasn't, but it is now.
Who
hasn't
been
just
drinking?
Walk?
I don't drink.
Cool. Toss him the keys.
All right, Rain, you drive.
I've never driven before.
It is, of course, not a traditional bounty board because bounty hunting is technically illegal in the city of Lost. But underneath the heading of odd jobs and unique acquisitions, there are 3 letters tacked.
Probably have money, so that should be a good one.
The other
Hand
two,
that one off to you.
The other two are in your chat.
We have to find Belle.
Huh?
What?
We have to find Belle, everyone.
Who's Belle?
Do you want to show that to the rest of the team?
Belle is this person's dog, and it ran away.
Is that a dog? That looks like a pig.
I think that's...
Belle pays... They're going to pay us in Xanax?
No, Belle ran away.
Oh, dare you.
Hey, I didn't know...
It kind of does look like a word.
Belle ran
Xanax
away.
Xanax free to a good home.
Some missing case goods. Should be an easy job. Guess the police won't help him look. If we find our way downtown, we just gotta stop at the armory.
Alright.
Waiting for help there.
Understood. But just in case, could you say that all over again?
Maybe when you're sober.
Did a student put up this ad?
What if Belle's an endangered creature?
Then we will definitely find her.
Belle's a dog.
Can I have my passive perception reduced for anything except a lost dog?
Can I make active perception checks looking out the window for a dog?
Would you like to?
I would like to. Throughout the ride, yeah.
Give me a roll.
Come on, don't screw me. 18.
You do not see a dog, however, you are pretty confident that there's an enchantment on this paper to lead you to a house.
Guys, this is written in magical crayon.
You park off of one of the main roads into one of the lots. Near boxes of ore coming down from the mountains, and you get a good view of the whole wharf. Would anyone like to take any actions? Anyone want to do anything?
Can I keep an eye out for a tall, brown-haired Goliath?
Absolutely, give me a roll.
I'm going to look for a dog.
Okay.
I got a 12 for dog.
No dog.
I'm Lots also going to look for Belle.
Give me a dog roll.
Oh,
That's a natural 20, my friend. You see a dog walking on its hind legs. What do you see, Tom? Wow, you really got him.
You see
a dog.
Dog's footprint. You see the footprint, and it leads sort of down and around underneath one of the docks. You find your way under the dock, very far away from the plot. Several iron rods covering the half moon entrance to a sewer system.
I'm gonna break it open.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna help.
What are we doing? Why are we breaking into sewers all of a sudden? I thought we were looking for a Goliath.
Bell is down there.
I thought it was
Bell?
The dog, Ring. Is there a dock worker nearby?
Yeah, you think you can reach out and grab one?
We'll find you.
Hey,
you are.
You. Where's your boss's office?
Okay.
Over gotcha. There. The Goliath stops as they are sort of heaving back on a big dolly to take a big load of boxes. And
yeah.
Turns and the thick eyebrows knit together. Is it me you're looking for? The individual takes the envelope and you sense that this individual casts detect magic on the envelope. In a low, grumbling tone, the Goliath says,
"Is he sure? We're stretched pretty thin already."
I don't know what that thing says. Just a messenger.
We didn't look. Messengers. We're new to whatever's going on.
We're new to Vegas, so.
Yeah.
Very well. We'll be ready.
As you are walking away, you hear him mutter under his breath as he is heaving the dolly back.
Dangerous times.
He's been kidnapped!
Oh, no, no.
Did you go in or are you just standing outside?
Oh, no. After about a minute, I got bored.
Oh,
so,
this is fair.
I shook my mushroom and I grew a giant mushroom in the sand.
You successfully shake your mushroom and grow a giant mushroom in the sand.
He's standing under a dock.
What's seashore?
And there he saw a rock. It wasn't a rock, it was a mushroom.
You know someone's probably going to yell at you for squatting, right?
But I'm standing.
What's everybody's vision status?
Dark vision.
Mm-hmm.
Dark vision.
No dark vision.
I do not have dark vision, but I do have glowing mushrooms.
Oh, I got glowing mushrooms?
Yes.
Yay. How do you have glowing mushrooms?
I pick them instead of torches.
Kitty wants to play D&D.
Oh no, our viewership. Everyone hates cats.
The worst.
Oh, Tony made a friend.
You see a couple of ripples pass through the water. You're pretty sure that there is something moving, something very large moving in the water. Somewhere ahead.
That's a big dog.
I'm gonna preemptively cast Mouse Minute Meteors.
Who's leading the way?
The only person visible right now.
I am. Yeah, I throw up Mel's Minute Meteors, and I start moving forward, and okay. I kind of say...
I think you mean Lelf's little lightning balls.
Got him. You come to another three-way intersection. The water is churning, it seems, somewhere to the left. Any individuals who can see at this distance, perhaps 60 feet away... As you get closer into view, comes a large, wide room. And this room seems to have a pool in it, coming from some creature beneath the surface. You hear some soft growling and thrashing and bubbling gnarls.
I'd like to ready my rifle.
Okay.
I would like to call out to it.
What would you like to say?
Hello!
Google, you step forward and staff in hand call out, "Hello!" And you see the movement in the pool suddenly stop, and a shape large and mossy and mottled green, with a long, thick snout with thick, razor-sharp teeth, rises out of the pool and glares at you with red eyes.
Is that Belle?
You can naturally talk to animals?
Yes.
Interesting. You get a sense that this creature is in a rage, in a panic.
I'm gonna cast a third level spell. I'm gonna cast Speak with Animals. Hello, friend. What is your name?
The big mossy creature barks and says, "Bell." Damn it!
What's wrong, buddy? Why are you so angry?
You get the sense from the creature's frantic, panicked movements that it is stuck.
I will cast at fifth level.
You cast Dispel Magic at fifth level, and this large, mossy creature, still agitated, feels magic wash over it and begins to panic and rage, and it starts to leap, and as it is jumping, it whoop, shrinks down to the size of a golden retriever, and pops down in the water.
You guys, I found Belle.
Come here, Belle. Who's a good
guy? I told you it was Belle.
This dog, looking deeply sad, deeply upset and unnerved, coughs and sputters, and out of the green jaws of this creature spits a ring that sort of flutters.
I'm sorry, Zach, you got me
to the punch. So you just grab it?
Yeah.
Would you like to investigate it?
Sure.
Investigation or Arcana?
Arcana, absolutely.
With your bare hand.
Yep. You have a talking coat. I don't want to hear it.
Yes, because I touched it with my bare hands. Put on a glove.
Arcana 30.
But I was the one with bare hands.
This is a ring of growth. You think that if you put it on, you'll get big.
I'm gonna put that in my pocket.
And it seems to you that the dog accidentally got lost down here, found something, accidentally ate it, and then
naturally.
Got big.
Target specific area? Never mind.
We'll cross that bridge when we get there. It's not that kind of ring.
You don't need to make your head even bigger.
That's a great encounter, everybody.
I thought we were gonna be in combat.
Yeah. The dog.
You were gonna
goes
kill
on
Belle.
I was waiting to.
Oh my goodness.
The dog goes into Google's lap in the back of the car as we drive.
Okay, you guys come on up to the surface, and boop, boop, brrr, the car folds out, and you take one of the long beachfront roads on your way to your next destination.
From world-class assassin to dog walker.
There's a restaurant serving various fishes and pastas. And around the corner of the restaurant, there's a set of stairs leading to the second floor with a little sign tacked to the wall that says Alohir Continental Wildlife Conservation Commission and an arrow pointing up second floor.
Oh, I brought Belle with us.
At the center of it all, in a tweed coat with a pair of tiny glasses, is a kobold pouring over an old manuscript. And this individual looks up and he says, "Hello, are you here about the manticore?"
We're here for animal communications.
We don't start teaching that class until next summer. You are answering the ad, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
You are intrepid adventurers.
Yeah.
No, my name's Google.
The individual pulls from a waistcoat.
They're going to say from a hat.
We're looking for ants?
A deck of cards that appear not to be dissimilar to tarot cards. And the individual shuffles them quickly and then sifts through them. What do we have?
It's so majestic.
Why are we even here?
These are special cards that I have designed. If an individual is touched with one of these cards, it will attach to them. These individuals exclusively, as the recipes specific to the creature involved. You touch this to that creature, and then, shall we say, subdue the creature by means that I would rather not discuss, the individual will be ready for transport.
That's really useful. Wow.
This guy just got us to play tabletop Pokemon.
That would be ridiculous.
We'll see what we can do.
You weren't supposed to realize that for another couple of sessions.
I read you like a book, Tyler.
Let's go!
What is that place?
This Oasis. Is Oasis.
I didn't see that.
Nobody say anything. It's okay. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's cool. It's fine.
Bam. Oasis, that's where we did the fiddle play.
What are you fiddling with over there?
Excuse me.
What?
I don't mind what you do in the comfort of your own home.
Oh, wait, that's
the fiddle, the restaurant.
That's where we played in front of that really wonderful wall, right?
That,
right?
That's, yeah,
yeah, right
yeah,
by
the
Oasis.
One, the
that's
yeah,
right.
Yeah, that's right.
How dare you?
Right, so if we come across a manticore, we can kill it. Perfect. That's all I needed to know.
No, I was saving it from killing them. Saving them from killing it.
Wait, you
You are that? A confusing person.
You are projecting.
I agree with you.
The individual shuffles to the other side, pulls a projector out with a whole bunch of little slides of different animals. No, this is projecting.
I leave.
Okay! Hundreds, maybe thousands of individuals and tents and huts. They each have a vendor inside. You see some with fresh fish, some with fresh bread, some selling wares, some selling strange esoteric items. You see beaded jewelry, fresh baked desserts, and lemonade. You see people shouting about upcoming events, offering free samples, and in the swing of the trading season, even games and challenges scattered all about.
Yeah.
I share my lemonade with Belle.
Oh.
You pour it out, you go...
And she goes, does that...
And she does that thing where it's a little too sour, and she goes...
Do we have an aquatic porcupine? Dog.
The dog pants and runs around you again and wraps your legs up again. You pass someone passing out free samples of fried dough.
Oh, I'm gonna run over and grab it.
Wait, you grab the whole tray?
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, these are all free? Thank you.
You pass a couple of games hawkers along the way. There's a person with one of those like test your strength games. There's a person with one of those sort of guess the number of beans in the jar games. There's
only
a,
Talos was
there
here.
Is a,
yeah.
A
he'd clean shop at that strength.
There is like an old style wagon.
She'd clean
in
shop.
Purple and black motley. That sounds delicious.
Prestidigitized.
I love a good fried sauteed prestidigitator.
No, not the tater.
You know, prestidigitators, boiler mash.
Mashem throw in a stew.
Not too far down, you see a halfling in dark clothes on top of a small stool with like a tray of ice out in front. You get the sense that this individual, though on the older side now, might once have been a very skilled rogue. Her eyebrows, which are salt and pepper at this point, sort of knit together. Took him long enough.
Three readies. All
what
right,
are we doing?
Delivering messages. And dogs.
Is there a games booth nearby that has stuffed animals for prizes?
You see a game with a ball, and the objective is to throw it and knock over a stacked set of pins.
I am watching closely, and also probably asking Rain to look closely to try and see if there's any sort of rigging to it.
Okay.
I'm going to whip it. 17.
A 17... knocks over the top pin and the second pin, but not the third.
Did we see anything?
Give me a perception check, please, with advantage because you readied it.
29.
This ball is some kind of weird. There is some sort of mechanism in this ball that seems to spin after it leaves an individual's hand. You can sort of see it vibrating as it goes through the air. Mm. You think that if you throw this ball light, it'll have a better chance to hit.
If I were to cast Fairy Fire on the pins, would that make them easier to hit?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna beer pong throw it.
Riley, you do like a little lob, and you think it's gonna miss, by just a hair to the left.
No.
And a gust of wind, you do like one of these.
Yeah.
A gust of wind pulls it back on track and you knock down all three pins.
Yes! What can I say? What are you celebrating for?
Because you're my brother.
Take the platypus.
Yeah, it pulls down a big old plush platypus and you take a big old plush platypus home.
Is it teal and orange?
No, it's orange. It's orange and teal, actually.
Uh-huh.
Perfect.
That was so worth the dollar. Oh, yeah. All right, let's go.
There's a couple of other games. You guys want to head out or stick around?
What other games are there?
One of those test your strength games. There's one of those guessing games, and there is a games booth in black and purple lobby.
Oh, I want to do the strength game.
Go on then. Please make an attack roll.
Shillelagh.
Please do.
I'm not even going to be subtle about it. I go, boom.
Ha!
Yeah!
As you are pulling back to swing, you see this person slip their foot underneath to lever the button up to make it harder to hit. And you hit it so hard that lever comes back down on his foot. The weight goes all the way up, rings the bell at the top, and you see this person jump and fall over. You win a giant bag of caramel.
Yo!
It's about yay big, and amazingly, it just fits into your pack. There is a giant jar of beans about this big and this far around.
Can me and try and figure out the rig for this
sure,
game first?
Sure, absolutely! Please roll investigation.
I have not been rolling well tonight.
It's a 19 and 11, so a 22.
There's mirrors in this thing.
Whatever we see in the front.
Yeah.
It's quite a bit smaller than it looks, without even looking at it. I'm so sorry, that is not the
correct I'd like to see a count on that, sir.
Certainly not. We don't count the beans until the end of the day. We know the number that is inside this jar.
Oh, yeah?
Absolutely.
Well, and, we just played, so how
do we know? Because, like, right now, I'm feeling like there might be something shady going on. If you're refusing to actually count and prove that I'm wrong.
I figured out the thing you're running. I've seen the scam. I know what you're doing.
Look, dude, I'm just trying to make a living.
I mean, I guess they're right. I did the thing.
Fine. What? Take a thing.
Water pistol or marble? The marble's the
water pistol.
Water pistol. That's it.
You take a water pistol and you put it away.
Yeah. We've cleaned up today. I've seen how
you could spray people in the crotch and it looks like they peed themselves.
Brandon, you walk up to a little shooting gallery. It's inside like a makeshift wooden. Like almost saloon looking thing. You walk in through two little double doors.
So just like a totally modern building.
And there is there's a wide counter with some little BB rifles standing.
Yeah. Ray says, I brought my own.
Can we do the same check for the rig?
You certainly can.
17 investigation.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's kind of on the edge.
It is. With 18 minutes left, you successfully find the ring. You sort of lean back a little bit, and you watch some people, you watch a person or two play.
Right.
It's a pretty popular attraction. And in watching them, you see that a person manages to score 8 out of 10. And then, as they are moving to the side, two of the ones that they had already shot down come back up. Please do me a favor and make 12 ranged attack rolls. Brandon, what is your bonus to this?
Yes.
Plus 9.
Oh, perfect.
I have 1, 2, and 1, 3.
You knock out 8 of them, and then you pause for a moment. You see it's just the last 4 that they told you were rigged. You hit 2 of them, and then two of them pop back up, but the last two do not have time to pop back up before the light goes off over your head. You have won, and the individual looks really surprised and a little concerned, but like looks around and no one seems to be noticing that their targets are popping back up. So they just, like, quietly are like, congratulations, friend, you have won, and passes you a pistol. Would you guys like to stop anywhere on the way back to Desperate Measures Bar and Grill?
Wherever the thing for Belle is leading us.
The dog gets really excited when you turn down onto the last street. Cat, you don't need to sit on the plate. That's okay. The door opens.
It's in your folder, so we don't lose.
And an individual of a sort of persuasion that none of you really recognizes steps out. This individual is tall with green moving limbs, but they are covered head to toe in some thin little spikes. And from behind, another very small individual runs through the legs of the older individual in a set of work overalls. And this kid in a little sundress runs over, unlocks the gate, and says, "Belle!" And the dog, like, hops and, like, starts licking the face of this little cactus person.
Does Belle, is she still holding the giant platypus?
So the child is at risk of being smothered by a platypus stuffed animal.
I'm just going to see if you're going to pay us, but I'll take it.
Magic.
I understand.
We are the only tracti in town. It is hard for us to find work. We do not have much money.
Yeah, that's...
But if ever there is something that you need, know that you can ask us.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to take out of my coin purse $2,000, leave it on the front door, knock, and then run. And if they can see me, I'm casting invisibility on myself.
Yeah, I probably also slide $1,000 your way to add to that.
You successfully slip $3,000 into this person's mailbox.
You could learn a thing or two.
Yeah, you didn't pay anything.
I understand in the line of work that we have it pays to not have a heart, but, you know, sometimes.
Yeah.
I have a heart. I would be dead if I didn't have one.
You ever heard of a metaphor, Rain?
You guys pull your car up near the bounty board, and you hop out. The street is still quite mottled, quite potholed. You hop out.
One of our hubcaps goes rolling off down an alley.
Leon is behind the bar, serving a drink to a person in a work outfit. I did go.
It went well.
There it is. There's the accent.
It went great. We delivered everything
without a hitch.
That's spectacular.
Yeah. And we'll be ready from Lauren. We're stretched thin, but we'll make it work. From Theo or something along those lines.
He doesn't have the jovial smile that he did before. He looks a little tired, a little careworn.
I saw this coming.
And he pulls out a piece of paper. I've been working with a couple of the organizations around the town. I'm something of an organizer myself. And things are not going as well as I'd like them to. He slides a letter. This is what I had you deliver. Pick it up, and it reads very simply, negotiations have broken down. Strike starts at midnight. And that's where we're gonna end for today.
Get to be a union thug!
Really is all about
it. That's our session. That's excellently done, you guys.
Yeah.
I didn't expect the whole dog subplot to be done today, but that's off the books. There it is. Everybody say goodbye.
Goodbye.
We love you. And that 22-second clip of me not saying anything is going to be really funny.